Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Hard Time series in Kerbal Space Program 0.25. When we last left Jeb and Bill, they were in orbit around Eve, and here they are right now. And they have a escape trajectory back to Kerbin, but it's going to cost 741 meters per second of Delta V. It will get us an encounter with Kerbin, just barely, but we barely have enough liquid fuel and oxidizer to make this happen. So it's a tough call. I think we will try to make this maneuver instead of trying to refuel them here. If it turns out that we can't get them back into Kerbin, what we'll do is we'll try to rendezvous with them, much like we would with the asteroids if we were trying to pull them in. So we'll launch some sort of mission that will rendezvous with them in sun-centric orbit. I don't know if it's okay to call it heliocentric when it's Kerbal instead of our sun. But, yep, that's the plan. And that's to make things as simple as possible. Of course, if it does fail, if this maneuver fails and we don't get close enough to Kerbin, we will have to act fairly quickly to unlock docking ports in order to dock up with it. Of course, it's got its own little docking port here. I could make a pretty ugly sort of craft with this docking port on top, but that will not be the best thing. Basically, this series, so obviously 0.90 has come out, and it's got all these additional features, and in fact it's much, much more difficult than this series is, so it's really hard times if you play hard mode in the 0.90 version. But I think this series is worth continuing simply because we've got this shuttle. So basically this shuttle is going to be the mainstay of this series, because it doesn't work in any other series right now. My 0.90 series is a long ways off from being able to unlock this shuttle. 0.24 doesn't have the parts. The colonization series is in 0.25, but this shuttle won't work under FAR. It won't work under FAR because I've layered the wings like this. We've got actually three layers of wings going on here. And so actually you can see that it's got wing parts all the way down in the center there. And FAR doesn't like that. FAR basically thinks those cancel out and provide no lift, as far as I can tell. I've tried it out, and the vehicle just doesn't have enough lift to get to altitude. It can get off the runway, but it just can't get anywhere after that. I think the Rapiers are also a little bit underpowered under FAR, but I'm not sure. But yeah, it just couldn't get too far with... it couldn't get too far with FAR. Anyway, but that's the idea. So this is the only series where this craft actually works right now. It'll work in 0.90 beta, I'm sure, but I haven't unlocked these parts yet there, and it'll be a while before I do. So yeah, that's the situation. And so we're going to continue with this, and this will be the centerpiece of this series, I think. And so let's try and bring Jim and Bill back now. I think they've spent enough time in orbit around Eve. Our node is in 2 hours. First goal will be to just get into orbit around Kerbin. We can't really land it directly, otherwise we'll have a very low chance of actually hitting the runway. I guess we could hit, try and land on some terrain. We've got a surplus of liquid fuel to run the jet mode on, but it would still be pretty dicey to try and land it on terrain. Its wheels don't really extend very far below the body, so it has to be landed fairly carefully. Oop, passed it a little bit. Alright, well, here we go. Okay, let's shut it off for now. Let me see how we're doing as far as the actual approach to Kerbin. Okay, I don't sense it going down much more than that. Alright, now plotting some sort of maneuver in the middle in order to get closer to Kerbin. Let's hope this doesn't cost too much. Okay, so We either go for a number that's higher than 1,900 kilometers on the periapsis, or we get a moon encounter. Basically, if I try and get any closer than this, we get a moon encounter here. Not too sure which way I want to go with that. I think I'll avoid the moon encounter first before I... Well, I could focus on Kerbin. Let's see, can we take a look at what this moon encounter looks like? Tough to see and adjust the maneuver at the same time. That looks better. Still give us an inclination that we don't want in terms of getting close to the KSC. Should use this view more often though. Yeah, we'll need to get into orbit around Kerbin and then refuel. That means aerobraking, because obviously we don't have enough fuel to get into orbit manually. We need to get into orbit so that we can refuel and correct our inclination, I think. This thing doesn't have enough cross-range ability to turn around on its own. Now, estimating the aerobraking will be as tricky here as it was with Eve, because, of course, this is a body with a lot of lift on it, and that's going to complicate the numbers. Can't just use aerobraking calculator blindly when it's got this much lift. So, 12 days, and then we'll have this correction. Let's try and make sure this remains lit. Which side is the sun on? Oh, right behind us. That's helpful. Okay, looks like we're good to go. Heading out to the maneuver node. This is going to be tight. Okay, I'll do the rest with RCS. I should turn it off and point properly. Let's see, how close are we? Not far. Not far at all. Okay, well, I was thinking I was going to hit 30 kilometers, but I think it's just a little bit too fidgety for me to get that right. Okay, well, 42 is fine. Okay, we'll have to get a little bit closer as we get in. But, yep, now let's see if this works out. Looks like we're on a good approach. We still might be flung out into interplanetary orbit, and then we'll have to do the asteroid-style rescue. Wow, that is a horrible inclination, but no matter, that's... Oh, and we're actually 81 kilometers above Kerbin. Not what I wanted, but our main duty now is to get into orbit, and so after that we'll worry about the rest, I suppose. Can we correct inclination? I don't know. I mean, that's a lot of delta V you're talking about right there. And then we have to also bring it in tighter. Okay, it looks like around 34.6 meters per second to flatten it out. I'm currently assuming that my oxidizer is basically equal to the amount of delta V I have in these engines. So I'm assuming that this will pretty much do it for me. Yeah. So that's the situation. Our periapsis after this will be at 28. I don't know if that's enough or not, but aerobraking calculator is not going to give me a better estimate, I don't think, given the fact that this is not a blunt body. Now, I'm going to do it right now to save as much delta V as possible, since if I wait, it'll just cost more. Okay, well, it's as good as I can get. It looks like we'll end up flat, but it's not true. We'll actually still have a pretty serious inclination, but it's not going to be as bad as the one we had going in the first place. So now we've got 28 kilometers periapsis. Let me check what aerobraking calculator has to say, just in case. So hold on a sec. Okay, so aerobraking calculator says I should be at 32 kilometers Certainly not 28, so I'm gonna back off from this a little bit. And probably radially. Gonna go for 30, let's say. Again, compensating a bit for the fact that I have wings. But I'm probably not compensating too much for that. Let's see. Alright, that's 30. So I'll try that. It's tough though. Real tough. Should I just go with 32 like Airbreaking Calculator says? Yeah, maybe I should. Let's go there. Alright. Here we go. And yep, let's take it from the external view. Got a little thing going there. Don't know if that's Minmus or something else, some other transient there. No, it can't be Minmus. Must be something else. So it looks like we'll have some inclination with KSC if you can take a look at the direction we're going in here. Looks like maybe about 10 degrees, 12 degrees, that sort of thing. Okay, here comes the atmosphere. This craft is designed to be balanced, so I trust that we are not going to flip out at this point. Though maybe hugging the prograde vector a little bit better might help. Pointing high is mainly a way of gaining lift. And we don't need that. We want to be blunt body as much as possible. Okay, well, we're not slowing down too much yet. And we're only 8,000 meters away from our periapsis. Need to burn off something like... Well, I mean, we'll probably get into orbit without any problem. It's just how high in orbit. Ooh. Still not going up just yet. Now we're going up. Alright, it looks good, I think. I think it looks okay. Alright, well, the Derek shuttle is back at home in orbit around Kerbin. We could put it into a stable orbit. I think we have enough fuel to boost its periapsis so that it'll be back into a stable orbit. Or we can try and bring it down. Which might be tricky because we're not at zero inclination here. By the time we make a full orbit, KSC will be on the dark side, probably around here somewhere. Doesn't seem like that's a good idea. So, I think we're going to have to park it up here and try and refuel it, but at least it got back. It's not going to have much spare fuel. They got me waiting for a while. Let me just plot it to see how much it's going to take to get into a stable orbit. That's a lot. It'll depend on how much mod propellant we have. I mean, how much delta V we have in our mod propellant, I should say. Okay, here we go. Where's Kerbin? There's Kerbin. And so we're gonna try and get into a stable orbit here. Let's start off with RCS. Not a great source of delta V, but better to dump it anyway. It'll make the main engines a little bit more efficient. Let's try and give them a go. Just a tiny little bit of... There we go. Wow, not much. Basically gonna expend all the fuel except for the liquid fuel we have to spare. Wish I could dump that, but can't right now. If we could dump it, we'll have a little bit more delta V, but... But I think we'll get into a stable orbit, I hope. Of course, if we're at like 16.8 or something like that, it's not gonna be a big deal. So probably should increase the amount of oxidizers, right? Well, this was on the shuttle version. Of course, on the regular DRK, we needed the surplus of liquid fuel to get up, but with the shuttle, maybe I need to add some more oxidizer to it. That's the mop propellant done. And that's the end of the main engines. And we are at... 926 kilometer by 78 kilometer stable orbit around Kerbin. Alright guys, now we have to figure out how to get some fuel up to you so that you're not going to be stranded up here for a very long time. Let's do the thing where we orient normal so that we can get maximal sunlight. Can't quite get my angles right, but there we are. Okay, so let's go back to the KSC and see what we can do for these guys. So basically what we need is 160 science to unlock these docking ports. And right now we have 17. Taking a look at the science archives, obvious targets are the Mun and Minmus. Mun is pretty well covered. Got EVA reports, goo, high and near, though it doesn't seem like we've done mystery goo on the surface, does it? We've got surface samples. But we didn't bring the mystery goo down to the surface, so that's the thing. Mobile Material Lab, we also didn't bring the Science Junior to the surface. So we could do a unmanned probe to the surface of the moon and get some like that. Minmus, same situation. We could probably do a mystery goo plus the Science Junior to the surface, and that'll cover it. EVA reports above Minmus are covered, though we could do the whole landing and taking off, though we've already done two EVA reports from the surface, so I'm loath to try and just do a lot of hopping like that. Plus the hopping would be a lot easier with the Science Junior and mobile materials. So yeah, that's the situation. Oops. So yeah, I think we need an unmanned lander to grab some science from these two bodies. Let's try and make a lander that can handle both of them. Okay, so here's what I've come up with. A very different design than I normally do. I certainly don't usually put these airplane parts on my rockets, but it seemed like the thing to do in this case. It sure smooths out the lines on the rocket. So I decided that it would be a good thing. Hopefully its aerodynamics don't cause any sort of a unforeseen problem. It's a tiny bit less efficient than putting both this and this tank, which would contain an equivalent amount of fuel. So just a little bit, but otherwise it looks good and it's not a big difference. So yep, I've got the normal instruments except for the barometer on the top here. So I've unlocked the seismometer as well. Not the science, I just needed to pay for it, turns out. And yep, I decided to put one of these big parachutes here because, first of all, I can carry it down, but if you do the math, we'd probably need two of these radio mount parachutes which have the same mass as this one parachute but end up costing more. If I just tried to use this Mark 16, it probably wouldn't be able to carry all of this down with it. It'd be a close call. I don't think it could, honestly. We would at least need two of these radio mount parachutes, and in that case it's better to just use one of these. So that's that calculation for you. Otherwise, we've got lights, we've got antenna, we've got solar panels, we've got the solar panels action group, we've got one of the Rockamax 487Ss here, an LV909 here, with a fuel tank there. So second stage. This bottom stage will leave us short of orbit, And so we'll need this stage to complete orbit, transfer us to either the Moon or Minmus, bring us into orbit around the Moon or Minmus, and start our descent. And then this stage will be able to make the descent, land, get the science, and bring us back home to Kerbin. That is the plan. I'm hoping that this is going to be a quick sort of thing, and so I've named it Swift. And we are going to launch two of them right away, and that is one to Minmus and one to the Moon. So without further ado, let's bring this out to launch pad. Okay, here it is. A relatively cheap launch for us, considering the kind of funds we've racked up, so no big deal. We just really want to get the science in order to unlock the technology for docking ports. So here we go. Okay, going for pitch maneuver here. So far, so good. Very smooth so far, no problems. Nothing to worry about here as we get our orbit into shape. Could have done the inclination. I guess we could have done the inclination at the same time. It'd have been a little bit of a gap there. But no big deal, actually. Come to think of it, we could probably do an off-plane maneuver to meet up with Minmus. Let's see. Which means that we wouldn't need to correct our inclination at all. Okay, here we go. Orbit. That's the end of that stage, as expected. So it's gonna fall back down. Alright, that should be fine. Yep. Now let's see if we can do an off-plane transfer from this node here. Yeah, there we are. That's a high periapsis, but it's doable. Basically, that works if you can hit the target when burning out of one of your nodes. So, we can, and that's what we're gonna do. Oh, well, let's get solar panels out. I think we'll need at least this much time to do the burn. Oh, hold on there. Alright. Let's go. I forget whether we've done gravioli around places, have we? Let me just log gravity in. Oh, we haven't. Okay, well, let's transmit this bundle. We'll certainly want to do more lucrative science elsewhere, but might as well get this bit done. Okay, that's a pretty jittery encounter. Oh, there we go. Let's get rid of this. Not closer than I expected. Alright, so we've got a Minmus periapsis of 653, and that's good. Let's launch another one of these and aim it at the Moon. Up, it's a nighttime launch, but there's no time to waste. We've got two Kerbals waiting in orbit for their return home, and of course we called this the Swift Science Probe for a reason, so let's just get on with it. And here we go. Interesting. It seems to be making a rougher approximation on the Minmus probe. You can see bends in the trajectory there. Let's get this a little bit flatter. Okay, here we go for orbit. Okay, Seiko, and solar panels out. Very good. Okay, let's plot for our trip to the Moon. Looks like we should go around here. That'll be fine. 75 kilometers. Good deal. Up. Lunar eclipse. Oh, not a lunar eclipse. A solar eclipse. Solar eclipse with the moon. Up. Probably a little bit too far there. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, let's retrograde a bit. Just enjoying the view there. Ah, that's pretty close to periapsis. Let's get it to 50 at least. Alright. So, this too is on its way to its destination to grab some science so we can unlock docking ports. I think I'll handle the landings in the next episode. Seems like a better thing to do since I'm running out of time here. I don't know if I can get it done quickly enough. So, yep. In the next episode, I'm going to try and land both of these probes at their targets and then also bring them back to Kerbin so that we can get the science to unlock the docking ports so that we can rescue Jeb and Bill. Alright, so with that, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time.